live from Kauffman Stadium in Kansas City, Missouri. The show brings you a matchup of division rivals. It's the Cleveland Guardians going up against the Kansas City Royals. Joined by my partner, Chris Singleton, I'm John Ciambi. And we got a rubber match on our hands today, partner.
Yeah, the final game of a three-game set. They've split the first two, and regardless of how important a series is within the larger picture of the season, it's a game you want to get up for. Every series win feels good, so we should see a fun matchup in this one.
All right, we'll be back to get this one started after this. Just about set to go now. Pitching in our game today, Carlos Hernandez, and Singy, he likes pitching at home.
Well, truly for him, there is no place like home. He's been so dominant here, and as a teammate, you expect him when pitching at home this year to go out and dominate just as he has. The fans expect it, and I think everyone around here knows that he's a good pitcher. Even though we don't see the same splits on the road, we're going to start to see that translate as well.
All right, ready to get underway. Stepping up for the Guardians, Jose Ramirez. Next pitch is popped up. Mondesi gets under it and makes the grab. And there's one away.
Batting second.
Here's the Guardians lineup now. Someone who makes things happen for them, in part with his legs, Patrick Conley.
Well, he's been a very consistent performer this year. And, man, when you look up and you're in the top five in batting average in the American League, tell you what, that raises your level of confidence to keep it going and try to finish in that picture or maybe at the very top. He's been spraying the balls all over the yard. We're going to keep our eyes on him in this one.
Swing and a miss. That is strike two. Swing and a miss. The velocity blasted it right past him. And here is Patrick Conley. What a season it's been for him. He has supplied a lot of power and that average. And a count one and two. No score just getting started. Top of the first. In the air, right field. Olivares ranging back, makes the catch, inning over. Guardians go down 1-2-3. Half inning complete. We've got no score. There's the stream. Bottom of the first, Adalberto Mondesi up to the plate. It's interesting he plays kind of a power spot defensively, but runs pretty well. So when you're looking at that position, you're not expecting someone that has maybe above average speed, but he does. Slow roller to first, and that's a base hit.
Well, the last 10 games or so have been anything but fun at the plate for him, so that one has to feel good.
Mondesi on the move. That's in for a strike. The tag, and they get him at second. That's a double play.
Batting two. Not shortstop. Javier. Baez.
Now it's Javier Baez. And now it's even up. The wide to kick the pitch. And down on strikes. Royals set down in order. Second inning coming up here in Kansas City. No score. Now it's Franmil Reyes. Reyes hitting better against right-handers this year, so some reverse splits there. Swing and a miss. And that is strike two. And here it comes. Swing and a miss, and he struck him out. One away.
Toughest pitch to hit. Fastball on the outer black. Man, sometimes you just got to tip your cap.
Eddie.
Here's Eddie Rosario. Pitch misses. 3-1 now. Righty delivers. Swing and a base hit.
Everything came together perfectly for him right there. Breaking ball down and in. Did a nice job of just catching out in front. I like that he didn't spin off the ball by opening up that front hip too early.
And now the switch hitting first baseman, Josh Bell. A rope into right, and that's a base hit. Into third now. So runners at the corners and one out.
Showed some really nice patience in that at bat. Worked himself into a good count. Absolutely punished that pitch. Wasn't fooled in the slightest. 109 off the bat. I think that means you put a pretty good swing on it. Runner in scoring position now and a good opportunity to push across the first run of the ballgame.
So one out with two aboard. So in now for Cleveland, Brett Phillips. The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four.
So here we go again with the walks. It's been a real struggle finding the zone for him in the past. Now, even if they get out of this jam, these walks add pressure and stress to the entire team.
And now it's Ahmed Rosario. Fouled off. He was late.
He's mixing his pitches really well. Late on that fastball after seeing the changeup. See if he can elevate one. I think if he does, he'll get the swing and miss.
This one high in the air to left center. Ortega puts the squeeze on that one. Runners tag up from second and third. Run scores easily, and it's 1-0.
Batting nine, the catcher, Bo Naylor.
Bo Naylor digs in for the Guardians. Had the day off yesterday. Cleveland up a run looking for more. And that one in the air center field. Ortega makes the catch, and that'll do it. Now to the bottom of the second. It's the Guardians 1 and the Royals nothing. It ain't no surprise. A full moon sits in the sky. You better watch your... Back here at Kauffman Stadium. And now it's Salvador Perez to the plate. And a pitch. Fouls one off. 2-2. And a pitch. And a swing and a miss. That's one out in the bottom of the second.
Just a great slider right there. And I think the key for pitchers and what hitters don't want to see is if a pitcher misses with that pitch, that he misses off the edge of the strike zone rather than in the middle of the strike zone. And right there, excellent execution, and it finished up in a perfect spot. The designated
hitter, Eugenio Suarez, up to the plate now. Next offering is fouled back. Two down, nobody on. And a foul ball. The 1-2. Not even close there. 2-2. The 2-2. Now this is in the air down the line. Phillips, long run on his horse. Got it. Nice grab. And that ends the inning. Royals bats are quiet there, and it remains 1-0. Back here at the ballpark, now here's the switch hitting power threat, Jose Ramirez. Chris, baseball today, so many strikeouts, and they are available to pitchers. But this is a guy that puts the bat on the ball and is kind of different from the players that we see day in, day out.
Yeah, his swing is so good. It's in the zone a long time. He gets the barrel to it a lot, and that produces more base hits.
1-2 now. Just off the outside part of the plate. When you look at the elite teams in the game right now, there is going to be the slug, no question about it. But the really good offensive teams combine slug with more contact, with less swing and miss. Two down. And that one is lifted in the air. Fan settles under this one. And there's one down. Up next, now here is Jason Dominguez. He's 0 for 1. Dominguez. This one in the air, center field. Squeezes it. Two down.
Now batting, shortstop, Patrick Conley.
Two outs, base is empty. Stepping in is the switch hitting shortstop, Patrick Conley. 2-2 down. Pitch misses there, and it's 3-2. Left-hand batter waits. The right-hander gives up the two-out walk.
Boog, if I were him, I'd be nibbling around the plate as well. I mean, this guy is just capable of hitting pitches outside of the zone and driving them a long way.
Now it's the DH, Franmil Reyes. Good power, not great in the OBP department. Runner takes off. Pitch in for a strike. He is safe. That was close, but StatCast shows us why he so often seems to be on the safe side of these steal attempts, Chris.
Yeah, you see that plus speed, and he needed every last bit of it to swipe that bag. Such a threat on the bases.
Rolled over to third, and that one finds its way through. Conley rounds third, headed for the plate. He will score. It's 2-0.
Man, he just absolutely turned on that one, ripped it down the line. Nice job of staying in his mechanics. Rosario.
Eddie Rosario digs in for the Guardians. 1-2 now. Look out! And it hit him. He had him 1-2, and he ends up hitting him with a pitch.
Well, the bright side is that that will help the on-base percentage a little bit, and that's a category no batter can ignore these days. OBP, OPS, well, maybe that'll ease the pain just a little bit.
Awkward swing there from the big left-handed hitter.
Off balance as well.
Next offering is fouled back. And a pitch. Got him. Good job of damage control right there. But the RBI single pushes across a run. It's now a 2-0 ball game. As we go to the last of the third, Rafael Ortega stands in. Swing and a miss, and now 2-2. Next pitch in the dirt. Full count now. Back to work, 3-2 now. Rips that one center field. Puts it away for the out.
Batting it, the right fielder, Edwards.
So digging in, Edward Olivares. One down, base is empty. Bounced out to short. Conley gloves it. And two straight set down to begin the bottom of the third. Here's Tommy Pham. And the right-hander's 3-1. Lifted in the air, right center field. Snags it on the run. And that is the third out of the inning. KC down in order. They're still down. It's 2-0. Welcome back. All set for the start of the inning. Now it's going to be Brett Phillips. Line drive. Olivares makes the grab, and there's one down.
The batter number one, second baseman, Ahmed.
And here is Rosario. Ahmed Rosario. Next pitch has popped up. Guillorme pulls that one down, and there's two away.
Now batting, catcher, Bo Naylor.
Bo Naylor at the plate now.
Well, they've kept him pretty quiet in this series. Still doesn't have a knock. I know you want to get that first knock out of the way. Maybe more will come, but you got to give some credit to the pitching staff. They've had a great plan against him.
Next pitch, not close, up high. And that one sliced foul. Next offering popped in the air, right field. Olivares moving under this one. Drops into the glove, and that'll do it. Nothing doing for the Guardians there as they're unable to add to their 2-0 lead. Back here in Kansas City, and stepping in is the speedy Adalberto Mondesi. That one pulled foul. This one smashed down the right field line. Phillips racing over to make the catch.
Now batting, second baseman, Luis Guillorme.
Luis Guillorme steps in for the Royals.
Kind of a throwback. No batting gloves.
And he deals. Swings and lines a base hit into left field. The batter now, Javier Baez. He was a strikeout victim his first time. The 1-1 is cut on and missed to the pitch upstairs. Guillorme at first, one gone. In the air, left side. Rosario makes his way towards it, and he makes the catch. And there's two away.
The catcher, number 13, Salvador.
Now it'll be the cleanup hitter for the Royals, Salvador Perez. And it's fouled away. The next pitch misses. It's 2-2. Swing and a miss, and that is that. Royals leave one. They trail things here 2-0. And welcome back. We go to the top of the fifth. Here's Jose Ramirez. He's kind of an outlier, especially when guys are consciously sacrificing contact to deliver power.
The pitch. Boog, he never moved because he never had time to. But that kind of velocity, you'd prefer that pitcher work away.
Kicks and deals. To the right side. What a stop! On the money, nice play.
Nice dive and stop right there. Gets the out, great reactions. Excellent job of finishing the play with a nice, easy throw.
Next to hit, Jason Dominguez. The 1-2. And that one missing low.
Well, he might have to look for a different put away pitch right here, 2-2. He's already seen the curveball a couple of times in this at bat, so might have it timed up and ready for it.
Tap to first. And he grabs it, foul. The 2-2. Swing and a miss, and he got him. And he's down on strikes for the second time today. And now the shortstop, Patrick Conley. He's a guy who does it all.
This kid is so special.
He's a shortstop by trade and big time power. Line drive caught. Guardians fail to score, but they hold the 2-0 lead. Back here at Kauffman Stadium, John Schaube with my buddy Chris Singleton. It's set to get us started. Bottom five, C.J. Krohn. Someone always comes along, but there'll never be another. He swings and fouls one off. Pitch. That one back up the middle and it gets through.
Well, that was one of those high percentage advantage counts where batting averages are just so much higher. Good pitch, slider down and away, just stayed down and threw it nicely. Such an easy pitch to pull off of because you're probably thinking fastball down the middle initially. And you can feel this crowd waking up a bit here as the guys are starting.
This one's into the outfield, could be extra bases. Throw comes in, runner stops, second and third, nobody out.
Two consecutive base hits for these guys here. A well-deserved double on a great swing. Got everything going on time. He stayed balanced and he squared it up about as well as you could possibly ask. Now we'll see if they can pick up that tying run and start us over here in the late innings. That could jumpstart an offense that's really struggled to score in this one. Don't want to wake a team up with the free pass.
And a swing and a miss. Got him! Huge strikeout there.
Frustrating end to the at bat for the hitter, and I'm sure that's going to sit on him for a little while. You want to be ready to hit the fastball. Sometimes you can overthink things, and I think that was the case right there.
Now the left fielder, Tommy Pham.
And Boog, I'd say he's due.
Ground ball to first, could be two. Bell to second, back to first, double play. Nice job getting over, and that ends the inning.
Just trying to sneak one through with the bases loaded, but an excellent job by the defense to turn that one and get out of this jam.
Eric Ramirez taking over on the mound, and his job is to collect quick outs and keep his team within striking distance.
Well, at this point of the ball game, we're talking about middle innings, and you need a little length out of this arm coming out of the bullpen. We'll see just how many outs he's able to give his skipper.
Welcome back. Top of the sixth inning. Digging in, Franmil Reyes. The wind of the pitch. In the air, left field, Pham, reaching back towards the wall. Pulls it down and he makes the catch. One away.
the left fielder, number 9, Eddie Rosario.
So up next, Eddie Rosario. And now the lefty. They say it went. And a 1-2. That one to first. Crone takes it to the bag. Two quick outs to open the top of the sixth.
Now batting the first baseman, Josh Bell.
Josh Bell at the plate now. Line drive. That's a base hit.
Now batting, right fielder, Brett.
So two down now, and here is Brett Phillips. Next offering way off the plate. The 2-1. And there's a foul ball. Next pitch misses, and the count's full.
Great RBI spot here. Just got to stay focused on the pitch. The runner will be in motion, so something in the gap should definitely score it.
Fouled off again, and it remains 3-2. Bell off of first with two away. Out towards right center field. Ortega drifts towards it. And that is that. Top of the order due up in the home half of the sixth. It's the Guardians 2 and the Royals nothing. Well, we go bottom six. Here's a speed threat at Alberto Mondesi. And that one handled. Gets it to first. Leadoff man retired in the sixth.
The batter, the second baseman, Luis Guillorme.
Here's Luis Guillorme. Puts it in the air out towards left center. And there's two down.
Now batting, shortstop, Javier Baez.
And next up for the Royals, Javier Baez. Here's a 1-2. And now 2-2. And down on strikes he goes. That is the inning. Nothing doing for the Royals, and they're down 2-0. Josh Stamont will take over here. He's pitching on 2 days rest.
Number 63. Josh.
Back here in Kansas City, now it's the second baseman, Ahmed Rosario. Right side, hard hit. To first, one up, one down.
Now batting, catcher, Bo Naylor.
Here's the catcher to hit, Bo Naylor. Left-hand hitter waits. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. The pitch. Activity in the Kansas City bullpen. Taylor Clark up and throwing. Pyams, a hard-throwing right-hander, up as well. And a foul ball, he stays alive. Swing and a miss, and he chases that one in the dirt. Gets the out, two down after the strikeout.
Now batting, third baseman, Jose Ramirez.
Now it's Jose Ramirez.
And still looking for that hit to keep this streak going, and this might be his last shot at it, Boop.
The wind of the pitch. Now a high fly ball out to left center. Fan heading to the alley and puts the squeeze on that one. And that is that. The Guardians go down in order. They're up 2-0. Back here at the ballpark, and here's the catcher, Salvador Perez.
Well, these fans definitely want to get involved in the game. All it's going to take is to get the leadoff man or even a base runner on.
And the right-hander deals. And strike two.
It really looks like these hitters have been in between with their timing today. Good fastball, excellent slider, but they've not been able to commit to one velocity and stay there.
One away. Big timeout leading off the home seven.
Good late bite on that slider. Got the hitter out front, rolled over on it. Exactly what it was supposed to do.
Comes a pitch. And it's even up.
I think he was a little excited there, saw the fastball, but needed a stepladder to get to that one. He's going to have to tighten it back up. He wants to have a good at bat.
The pitch. That one down the line reaches for it, but it gets through. Stays alive. Kicks and fires. Swings and misses. And now two gone.
Well, I think he's got to be feeling pretty invincible out there on the mound right now. I mean, he's got the shutout working so far. And even when he challenges these guys, he's getting away with it. That pitch right there really wasn't anything special, a hittable pitch, but he gets the punch out.
Two outs, base is empty. Hey, Eugenio Suarez up to hit now. 1-2. And a foul ball, he stays alive. The next offering misses. Counts full, 3-2.
Well, just about to hit that century mark, 100 pitches for this game.
Fouled off again, and it remains 3-2. Three balls, two strikes, the count. Line drive, base hit. Two outs, runner at first. Now and to the plate for Kansas City, Rafael Ortega. Swing and a pop-up in foul ground. Makes the grab, and that's the inning. So one left for Kansas City. They trail it here 2-0. Welcome back, and a new arm on the mound to start the eighth. Joel Pyams hasn't pitched in the last 3 days. Oh, yeah. ready to begin the eighth, stepping up for the Guardians, Jason Dominguez. We talk about guys with good speed, and definitely he has it. But pushing the offense aside for just a second, Chris, it's the defensive side that I think the speed factors in the most.
Well, he gets to balls that get by most people at that position. Just really impressive, because there are certain times the ball comes off the bat, automatically that team that hit it thinks that they've got a base hit, or they may have extra bases, and he just takes it away.
Payoff pitch. Now fly ball to right center. Grabs it on the run. One down.
Now batter.
So digging in, Patrick Conley. This guy, one of the best contact men in the sport as well. Outstanding on the defensive end. Right-hander kicks, deals. Next offering misses down and away. In the air, fairly deep to right field. Olivares makes the catch. That's out number two. And now next is the designated hitter, Franmil Reyes. The 1-1. Look out, almost got him upstairs.
Straighten him up a little bit.
That one ripped right center field. That's back there. Up against the wall and brings it in. Guardians go down 1-2-3 as they're unable to add to their 2-0 lead. And welcome back. Bottom of the eighth. So up now for Kansas City, Edward Olivares. Now time is called here. Pitching coach on his way out to the mound. Manager out of the dugout now, and it looks like we'll see a change on the mound. That's it for Shane Beamer, and as he heads off, we'll step aside for a minute. Back with the new pitcher after this break. James Karinchak on the pitch out of the pen here, trying to protect this lead. And the righty deals. Bounce to the right side. The throw to first. One up, one down.
The lefty, number 33. Tommy.
Here's the left fielder, Tommy Pham. The pitch. So now 1-2.
It's been tough for the offense so far, but you can't get frustrated. You got to find a way to shake it off, go up there and relax. That's the only way you're going to be able to put runs up on the board.
The other way, and a base hit right there.
Well, that was an important at bat in this game, so great job there stepping up to the challenge. Totally tied up with that inside pitch. Got to it late and deep in the zone, but he got the bat on plane enough to fight it off the other way. Now a huge at bat in this game coming up.
Snags it for the second out.
Now batting, second baseman, Luigi Guillorme.
Now the number two hitter, Luis Guillorme. There's a 1-1. There's a strike.
Well, we call that keyhole. Even though it's right there and looks pretty good, if he doesn't love it, he's not going to swing that early in the count.
Popped up, foul territory behind the plate. Makes the grab, and that'll end the inning. Royals lead one. They're still down. It's 2-0. righty reliever out of the pen, Taylor Clark. It's his job to keep his team in the game.
Taylor Clark.
We go to the ninth. So in now for Cleveland, Eddie Rosario. Next one misses, 2-1.
Two ball, one strike.
Well struck, right field. That's back there. Pulls it in on the warning track.
It's a really good swing. He just didn't get quite enough of it to beat the wind. It's blowing in from right field right now.
Number 23, Josh Bell.
Here's Josh Bell. Right-handed reliever. That one fouled off, 2-2. And here it comes. This one bounced to Crone. And he takes it himself for the out.
Now batting, right fielder, Brett Phillips.
And the batter now, Brett Phillips. I think when you contemplate him as a player, the first thing you think about is defense, and you think about that great arm.
I also think about the speed. If he can get on, that's going to give one more thing for that pitcher to think about.
Next offering misses, and it's 3-2. Meanwhile, activity in the bullpen. Matt Barnes getting loose out there. Hawaii to kick the pitch. High in the air, out to right. Ortega ranging into the alley. And that's the third out. Part of the order, 3-4-5 will get their shot in the bottom of the ninth. It's the Guardians 2 and the Royals nothing. Here comes Emmanuel Clase out of the bullpen. Hasn't pitched in a while. He's had the last 5 days off.
Oh, he's having an excellent season so far. ERA is under 2. A lot of flexibility coming out of the bullpen.
Welcome back. Bottom of the ninth. And to the plate for Kansas City, Javier Baez. Next pitch is downstairs. Next one misses, and that's ball 3.
First pitch strike from the pitcher, but then no panic at all by the hitter. Very patient, showing good discipline. Now he's in the driver's seat with a 3-1 count.
Line drive, and there's a hit.
Now, just a nice job coming through in a pretty high leverage spot right there. That's a good sound coming off the bat, man. And as he connected out front and lifted into the outfield, that's one of those swings where you just don't even feel the ball hit the barrel. That's a pure stroke.
And a pitch. And a foul ball.
With 2 strikes. May see some movement over there at first base, trying to stay out of a double play here.
Swing and a high fly ball down the right field line. Phillips makes the play, and there's one down.
Now batting, first baseman, CJ.
And here is CJ Crone.
Well, look out here. He's going to come up ready to swing in this situation.
Baez stands at first with one out. Next offering is fouled back. Three, two on the way. Right through there. Got him. 2 gone now.
Well, he's going to have some thinking to do when he leaves the ballpark after this one. That was his 3rd strikeout. And this one looking, obviously. So he's been a little overmatched. He's got to find a way just to be more competitive up there.
Eugenio Suarez, the next to hit. Got him, and that's the ball game.
this is a huge win. Take this series on the road before heading back home. You go home feeling good about yourselves. You've got some good momentum. But at home, you also have a higher expectation to play well. So they're going to have to maintain the focus because those fans are expecting a lot.
2-0 your final here in this one. For Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show, I'm John Ciambi saying so long.
Feeling